Hi there. In this quick video, I'm going to show you how and when you should change the battery in your multimeter. Yeah, so if you have a multimeter similar to this one, you might get a battery low sign, as you can see it there, and mine also powers off. It's that weak. When you see that, although your multimeter might seem to still be working, change the battery. I left the battery in this thing until it even doesn't stay powered on, and I started to get wrong readings without even realizing that. So do not do what I did. When it shows you that sign, change the battery then and there. Okay, so how to do it? And yeah, if it gives you wrong readings, sometimes it's not obvious, and you will think, okay, that voltage seems okay, but it actually shows half of what it really is, or something like that. I'm just giving a random example. So battery sign, change it. To change it, remove obviously the leads from it. Take out the back. This is a rubber protection. You might not even have it, depending on the model. And in on the back, on multimeters, you don't really see those simple things like in remotes for your TV, for example, where you can remove just a simple cover and access directly the batteries. No, these things have screws almost all the time. So you need to take that those screws out, three in my case, and a lot of multimeters, especially bigger models, have 9 volt batteries. Smaller models might have AAA or AA batteries in them. How many depends on the model. 2, 3, 1. Again, it's not something fixed, but these bigger ones have 9 volt batteries. You can obviously find them in hardware shops. Don't overpay for them. I almost overpaid for a rechargeable one because I didn't realize. I saw kind of expensive. I wonder why that is, but eh. And then saw on the back, rechargeable. Okay, this thing cannot recharge it, and I'm not going to take it out, recharge it, put it back in. And the voltage of rechargeables sometimes is lower than the battery of the same shape and size. So yeah, okay. When you are here, make sure you don't move the wires too much to crack them. Simply unplug these connectors from the battery. One side, and yeah, sometimes they get really stuck in there. If they get stuck like mine did here, put a screwdriver, poke yourself in the finger, no, don't do that, and pull like this, using the edge of the battery to give you a bit of leverage until you get this thing out. Also, although I don't think I'm pulling on the right thing, no, that's actually the battery itself. What we need to take out is at the top here on this side. Yeah, and it's out. Let's unbox the battery. This is really interesting and important for me to show you. You need to unbox the battery. Anyway, so simply plug it in and push on these things until they clip in place. And that's that. Put the battery back in. Okay, moved it a bit too much. And put back the cover and screws. And I will do this in high speed because, yeah, it's kind of almost over at this point. And now Voila, this thing is on. And it is that simple. And some of you will wonder, why does this video actually exist? Not everybody has the same level. Somebody might have a multimeter and he uses it only to check continuity. That's all he does with it. He might actually never have opened up one of these things to see what's inside, how the battery looks like. So again, not everybody has same level. I've seen simple videos that are actually searched for a lot by people because they simply do not know, never encountered this situation, and they don't know how to solve it, if I can say like that. So yeah, let me just by curiosity check the voltage of the old battery, which is the positive. This one is the positive. And before, when I was on volts, because the battery was low, this was all over the place. It was changing constantly. Yeah, so if you are just taking the voltage into consideration, you might think, 9 volt battery, 8.8 volts, that's not bad. Yeah, but when you try to draw some current from this thing, that voltage will drop dramatically. So although the voltage seems good, this cell is actually done for it. So yeah, that's about it for this video. Thank you very much for watching. Hopefully it helps at least one person out there. And yeah, if it does, give it a like, check out my other videos, subscribe to my channel, and as always, see you in the next one. Bye.